Good afternoon, friends. Welcome to my channel, Pediatric Classes. Today, we are going to discuss about IGRA, that is interferon gamma release assay. Many are having lots of doubts regarding what is IGRA, how is it done, how can you interpret the results, and lots more doubts regarding the topic. And in Kerala, we are almost going to roll on the program. The IGRA is almost getting done. The training programs are many places have started, and some places it is planned for next week and all. So that is why I thought I'll take this topic up. So hope you have subscribed to my channel. If you have not yet subscribed, kindly do subscribe and please do watch. So let me start sharing my screen now. Sorry, there's a slight technical error. Let me just clear it up. Okay. I'm sorry. Yeah. Okay. So now we are going to discuss about the IGRA, that is interferon gamma release assay. In the previous video, I have discussed in detail about LTBA, that is the latent TB infection. And the goal of testing LTBA was to identify the individuals who are at increased risk for the development of active TB. Okay. So currently, there are two tests to find out the latent TB, that is the tuberculin skin test and an interferon gamma release assay. In Kerala, with the latent ABI, the detection, the NTP and IAPS formulated the protocol there, we are actually going in and using IGRA test as the main test for detection of LTBI. Both of them, that is both the tuberculin skin test and the IGRA, depend on the cell-mediated immunity, that is the memory T-cell response. A positive result suggests that the patient has been exposed and sensitized to mycobacterium tuberculosis in the past. TSC, that is the tuberculin skin test, as you all know, otherwise it is called as MANTO skin test method also. In the MANTO, what we do? Here, we inject intradermally purified protein derivatives into the volar aspect of the forearm, and the skin induration is read after a period of 48 to 72 hours. The ballpoint technique is used, that is like we roll a ballpoint along the horizontally, which is a previously, horizontal and vertical induration was measured, but now the horizontal induration is measured. When the induration, suppose you roll on the hand, aspect you roll, and when the induration is felt, we stop there. The other side also we roll, and when the induration is felt, we stop and we measure the horizontal induration. If it is more than 10, it is taken as positive. In about IGRA, that is this here, the tests are done in vitro. In vitro means what? Outside the body. Instead of PPD, here we are using very specific peptides from two main antigens. That is like ESAT6, early secreted antigenic target, that is ESAT6, and CFP10, culture filtrate protein. So these are the two tests. Neat aspirants, please note, there may be a question related to what are the antigens used for in IGRA that you have to label as ESAT6 and CFP10. About the commercial IGRAs, this one is a Condiferon TB golden tube. Another thing is a T-spot TB test. Then in IGRA, here a person's immune response is checked to the proteins found in mycobacterium tuberculosis. IGRA is a very specific test because this is not affected by the BCG vaccine. This is not affected by infection by non-tuberculous mycobacteria. So, we may get a positive reaction even if the patient has some non-tuberculous mycobacteria. Whereas IGRA is very specific because we are using a very specific antigenic proteins which are found in mycobacterium tuberculosis but not in non-tuberculous mycobacteria. That is why IGRA, we will get very specific results, okay, compared to our TST. Coming to the procedure of doing an IGRA, first thing is we need to collect the blood. Okay, how many samples we require? Minimum, how much ml we require? That's all big questions. So many doubts. So I will just see the lane from there. So collect blood means here we collect blood into three collection tubes, actually minimum three. So one is a nil gray tube, another thing is a TB antigen tube, another thing is a mitogen tube. Sometimes in TB antigen we'll have two separate tubes. Some realize we are using three things. So let us see in the program when it going to get rolled out in Kerala, how many tubes we are going to use. Probably three or four. In the nil gray tube, it is a negative control. This is used to adjust for the background noise when we actually put it for testing later. In the TB antigen tube, this is a very important tube where we actually coat the tube inside is coated with the antigen, that is SI6 and CFP10. This, once it gets mixed with the blood, interferon gamma will be produced by the white blood cells from the individuals with TB infection. Okay. Then we have a mitogen tube. Mitogen are a positive control. Purple cap tube serves as a positive control. That's interferon gamma positive control for each of the specimen tested. We need to fill 1 ml. There is a range. We can go for 0.8 to 1.2 ml, but the correct mark is for 1 ml. Suppose you fill 3 or 4 ml accidentally in a single tube, we have to discard that and take another tube and redo the sampling. Okay. This IGRA test measures the release of a substance called gamma interferon by whom the white blood cells in the patient's blood when these cells are exposed to specific TB antigen. So this is a basic concept of IGRA. So when the patient's blood is in contact with the antigens, okay? So a patient who is having an infection with mycobacterial tuberculosis, they will start producing the interferons against this specific TB antigens. Now, once the sample for the blood is collected, what should we do? We should actually shake the tube very nicely, around 10 times, just firmly enough to ensure that the entire inner surface of the tube is coated with blood. So here, so after 10 times shaking, what happens is you may see some frothing over the blood sample here. That is also no problem. That is not okay. This is to solubilize the antigens on the tube walls with the blood sample which you have collected. This will initiate the immunological reaction. Then what we should do once the blood sample is collected, then we need to, there are two different ways. One thing is we can transfer to the specific laboratories. Okay. So this should reach the laboratory within 16 hours of collection if stored at the room temperature, or within 48 hours if stored at 228 degrees. Delicious. The labs will be performing the IGRAs only on specific days. Now, once it reaches the lab, this has to be incubated at 37 degrees Celsius plus or minus 1 degree Celsius. Okay. So at least for 24 hours, 16 to 24 hours, they'll keep it incubated at 37 degrees Celsius. Prior to incubation, it will be at the room temperature. I told you, no? So after the incubation, what happens? After the incubation is over, that is incubation is at 37 degrees Celsius plus or minus 1 degree Celsius, we have to centrifuge the sample, okay, and perform the ELISA. See, after the shaking, one thing I wanted to tell, in certain places, they will have the facility to incubate. There, you can incubate for a day and incubate the sample and then send to labs for testing. Or we can directly send to the labs and there the incubation of the samples will happen. Whatever it is, after incubation, we have to centrifuge the sample, collect the plasma, and then complete the ELISA procedure. And the results will be interpreted using the QFT analysis software. So in short about the steps, there is sample collection, then we have to shake it nicely, then ship the samples. Samples and qualification, lots of criteria are there about the sample qualification, collection, transfer of blood, incubation of the tubes, post-incubation, then centrifugation, then collection of the plasma, doing the ELISA, then calculation, and finally the results are declared. Okay. So what is the difference between an IGRA and a tuberculin skin test? In IGRA, IGRA is an in vitro test. I already told in vitro means outside the body, whereas tuberculin skin test we do inside the body or we do it on the patient. IGRA uses well-specified antigens like SI6 and CFP10, whereas tuberculin skin test multiple uncharacterized and counterfeit antigens may be there. In IGRA, there is no boosting. Whereas in tuberculosis skin test, there is boosting. Boosting means suppose you give it, do a mandu today, and after a few weeks, generally at least 3 weeks gaps, but before if you do, there can be a boosting effect to the TSTs once repeated. IGRA is not affected by BCG, whereas tuberculin skin test is affected or may be affected by BCG. How many visits of patients require for IGRA? That's only one visit where the sample is collected. Whereas in tuberculin skin test, we have to do it on a patient, and later the patient has to come to us after 2 to 3 days for us to read the result. And IGRA have minimal inter-reader variability, whereas TSC have significant inter-reader. It may appear 9 to me, it may appear 11 to another person, it may appear 10 to another person. So there is always an inter-reader variability. And standardized TSCs are not available. IGRA results are mostly available in a day, whereas a tuberculin skin test will require around 2 to 3 days. IGRA is more than 99% specific, virtually eliminating the false positive readings, whereas TSCs, we have gotten lots of false positive readings from 3% to 65%. Both will represent the indirect markers of Mycobacterium tuberculosis exposure and already may be measuring the cellular immune response to MTB. How you read it? In TSC, ask how many millimeter of induration, whereas in IGRA, it is among, depends on the amount of interferon gamma released by the T cells. Neither can actually differentiate between LTVA and an active TB. That is why the test is positive. I told in the previous video and IGRA, and the test is positive, we have to rule out an active tuberculosis also. Then this has a low predictive value to detect the progression of the disease, and also it is low sensitive in immunocompromised patients. Standard of TB care in India, that is STC, clearly say that both the TST and IGRA should not be used for the diagnosis of active TB in highly endemic areas such as India. Now, how can you organize a test? The government has taken all the efforts to organize it in 46 public laboratories across Kerala, and also in 16 private laboratories also will be performing. So they have NTP has established specimen collection and transportation system from every center to transport the samples in a hub and spoke model. And lots of training programs are yet to roll on next week and the coming weeks. And I hope IGRA test is available as early as possible, so that it will help all the working pediatricians to find out and also to treat the LTBA in the most efficient manner, so that we can prevent or the development of the active disease in the children. I hope this session was useful for you. Please don't forget to subscribe. And if you like this session, please like it, share it, and also comment. Thank you so much and stay safe.